Hello everyone, I'm Jamie. Welcome to another session of this textbook services. In this session, I'll be taking you through the process of integrating 3D people from Google Tree website into a real life shot realistically. This will also depict the level of realism you can achieve with 3D people when compared against real photos. So without further ado, let's start by opening the 3ds Max file called Camera Match External Scene Underscore Trafalgar Square Main Google Tree. As you can see, the 3D people have already been added using some of the techniques described in the previous course about 3D people. Also, I've created a free step-by-step tutorial on Google Tree website depicting how the camera and the lighting were set up and matched accurately. You can always refer back to it if necessary. I'll leave a link in the description of the free tutorial. In the end, I've ended up with this 3ds Max scene. Because of the VRay exposure control settings, the current background image is white and cannot be seen. We're going to start by pressing A on your keyboard to bring up the environment effects dialog. Next, uncheck the option to process background and environment maps. Minimize the dialog. This is the camera that was previously matched. Let's maximize the viewport. These 3D people were placed in a scene using the same techniques described in the previous course referred to previously. As mentioned earlier, this is the follow-up from the previous course about 3D people. The 3D people were strategically positioned in a way that they would appear to naturally fit with the background photo, mainly because of the activity and interactions. For instance, that lady is not facing the camera and looking in the other direction as if she's taking a photo. To see the 3D people textures, click on wireframe text and choose the shaded mode from the list. You cannot see the guy speaking on the phone. There's that couple placed strategically so they look very natural in the environment they're in. Everything else is a photo. The sunlight and shadows were matched accordingly. We have the VRay sunlight and the VRay dome light here. Let's open the render setup. Check the Settings tab, open the Render Elements tab. Here, you have the whole list of the render elements added. The raw refraction, diffuse filter, the multi-mat, done in the exact same way as shown in the previous course. As mentioned earlier, you can always refer back to my other courses on my YouTube channel, blog and Udemy. Check the other settings and minimize the dialog. Once the scene was rendered, the final passes look like this. This is the RGB render pass. You might be wondering why the VRay sun highlights are not strong enough. It's mainly because in post-production, you want to be able to control it. Once the sun highlights are too bright in a render, it will be difficult to reverse in post-production. The best course of action is to have a little bit of brightness or highlights in the render, so you can later have the flexibility to increase or decrease it in post-production. Here, we have the VRay sunlight pass, which we'll later use to control the sun highlights on 3D people. Also, the ground object cannot be seen in a render because the alpha contribution option of the map properties was set to -1.0. It was set by simply selecting a ground object, right-clicking and choosing the VRay properties option. That is the alpha contribution option that was set to -1.0 with the map objects and shadows enabled. Close the dialog. Again, refer back to this article in the descriptions to see how the scene was set up. For this course, all that was done was to add a 3D people and render the scene. The following step is to take you through the step-by-step process of matching this raw render with a background photo 100%. To find and download the 3D people, I visited the Google Tree website. I've also clicked on the 3D people tab and browsed through their vast library of 3D models to find the right people for my scene. I've also filtered a selection by choosing some of their categories seen here. There's ethnicity, age group, season, activity, cycling, eating, sitting, standing, and so on. After that, I've simply downloaded them as shown in the previous video course. To begin doing the post-production work, let's start by opening Photoshop. In Photoshop, go to File and choose Scripts. Go to Load Files into Stack. In the Load Layers dialog, click on the Browse button. In the Render Passes folder, select the first file. Scroll down, hold down the Shift key, click on the last one to select the entire set of files, click OK to bring them into the Load Layers dialog. The entire list of files have been brought in. Click OK to load them up. They should start loading up as you can see here. They're all loaded now. The following step is to deselect everything apart from this RGB pass layer here. To do so, hold on Alt key on your keyboard and click on its eye icon. All layers are now hidden apart from the RGB pass. The next step is to color code the RGB pass layer. Right click on it and choose a red color from the list. Next, select and move it down to the base of the entire stack. The next step is to organize all the floating layers. Select the top layer and click on a group button to create a new group folder. Next, rename the folder as equal render elements equal. Select this layer. Scroll down. Hold down the Shift key and select the last layer on the stack, not the RGB parts. The entire set is now selected. Move them all into new group folder to keep them organized. Next, we're going to create a group folder for each of the 3D people in the scene. Let's start with the girl. Open the Render Elements group, turn on its layer visibility and go to the Channels tab. Hold on the Control key and select the RGB channel thumbnail, which is the alpha. The selection is now enabled. Go back to the Layers tab and turn off the visibility of the alpha layer. While the selection is still on, click on the Marquee tool. Hold down the Alt key to see the minus sign. Begin deselecting all selections apart from the girl by clicking and dragging while the Alt key is held down. Close the group. Select the main RGB layer and click on the Group button to create a new group. While the selection is still on, click on the Mask button to create a new group mask attached to it. The group mask is now created. All layers and adjustments created inside this group will be confined within the white mask seen in the mask thumbnail. Let's rename this group as equal girl with a camera equal. Next, we're going to repeat the same action with the remaining 3D people in the render. Again, open the render elements group and turn the visibility of the alpha channel layer. Go to the Channels tab, hold on the Control key and select the RGB channel thumbnail. Enable the Marquee tool again. We're going to create a group folder for this guy. Hold on the Alt key on your keyboard and begin deselecting everything apart from this guy's selection. Zoom out and deselect the other selections. Close the Render Elements group and select the RGB layer. Click on the Group button to create a new group. While the selection is still on, click on the Mask button to create a group mask. Let's rename this group as Equal Man Walking Equal. Next group to create is the guy standing with a phone. Go to the Channels tab, hold down the Control key and select the RGB channel thumbnail to enable the Alpha channel selection again. Enable the Marquee tool, hold on the Alt key and deselect all selections apart from the man standing with the phone. Go back to the Layers tab and select the main RGB layer. Click on the Group button to create a new group. While the selection of the guy is still on, click on the Mask button to create a group mask.